Hi and welcome to Inside Line. Now last weekend we were given a stark reminder of what can happen when things go wrong behind the wheel. The spectacular crash in the Mini Challenge race at Queensland Raceway has plenty of people asking questions about racetrack safety. Now Richard, what did you make about this apart from the fact it was one of the most spectacular pranks you've ever seen?
Yeah, I just could not believe that no one was seriously injured in that accident. I mean, it's frightening to watch, and the speed that the car seemed to gather over the couple of rolls that it did. It was just amazing that no one was killed.
It never looked like stopping before going over that fence, and then it ploughed into, from the camera angle, looked like it bowled over a number of people, but obviously they were extremely lucky. People walked out with relatively minor injuries.
Yeah, but I think you've hit the nail on the head there. I don't think there was much protection for that crowd at that racetrack, so it'll be interesting to see if we hear more about that.
It will indeed. I mean, I've always wondered at tracks, it seems so easy to be able to bowl over relatively short fences, but as you say, they're going to investigate, and who knows, we might have big NASCAR-style fences before you know it. Now, still on motorsport, it seems Ferrari's F1 team is in a bit of hot water about cigarette sponsorship. Richard, what's going on here?
Well, they've been taken to task by health authorities in Europe. Obviously, cigarette sponsorship is banned in motorsport, but they're running this logo that looks suspiciously like the bottom of a packet of Marlboro cigarettes on the back of their car.
Yeah, I mean, it looks like a barcode too, like it could be off almost any product you buy anywhere around, and I guess that's what they're saying, isn't it?
Yeah, and I mean, it looks like it, you know, it could go further than just Ferrari, because obviously Casey Stoner's team, Ducati, has the same barcode on the back of their bike, and they're sponsored by Marlboro as well.
Yeah, well, the rumours are obviously Ferrari's getting up to $100 million a year, which you would say would amount to sponsorship.
And you don't pay that for nothing, I would also point out.
Indeed, I'm tipping they'll want a return at the end of the day. Now on to more mundane matters. Now, over the past week or so, we've been driving a trio of cars that shut down their engines when you stopped, all with the aim of saving fuel. Richard, how'd you find them?
I found them really weird to get used to. I mean, I've driven the Prius before, and that's obviously got stop-start, but that's a CVT transmission, a type of auto transmission. This is different because the car actually conks out. I mean, the first thing you think of is, oh, geez, I better put the clutch in because this thing's going to stall. But once you get used to it, I mean, it works.
Yeah, well, I mean, you always struggle with trying to do two things at once. So I can understand that bit, but yes. Never mind.
No, it's true. But no, I think it's worthwhile. I mean, sometimes, you know, you've just taken your foot off the clutch and suddenly the light turns green, you've got to turn the car back on. I don't know if you're saving any fuel at all that. But
I mean, that's the thing. It all depends on how you're going to use the car. In really thick traffic, obviously it will save a bit of fuel. Yep. It takes a bit of getting used to. It was interesting, we had a Porsche Panamera a couple of months back, and that also had it, the first one with an automatic transmission. And the one thing that annoyed me was, if you were listening to an iPod, it would actually reduce the volume when the engine cut out. So tiny little thing here and there that they've got to get used to. But hey, it's technology. I'm sure they'll get used to it. Now, still on the topic of the environment, it seems that Volkswagen is building an electric scooter to go in the back of a car, Richard. How does this work?
Yeah, well, it's obviously designed with the city congested traffic in mind. And I mean, you and I know you're sitting at the traffic lights and you see all the push bikes, you know, roll past you, and you think, wouldn't it be nice to be a bit more manoeuvrable? So this is the solution. You park your car on the edge of the city and then you get out the electric scooter and off you go. Happy days.
Sounds like a cracking idea. It's not quite the grand entrance to the 5-star hotel, but either way, as you say, it's got a lot of practicalities, and if it's not raining, could be a great way to get around.
Yeah, and I mean, it's electric, so you don't have to worry about turning up to work all sweaty and dishevelled.
And the best bit is you can recharge it off the car as you're driving, so it's ready when you get there. All good ideas. Anyway, that's it for this week on Inside Line, so thanks for joining us. Make sure you tune in next week. And in the meantime, log on to drive.com.au for all your motoring news and reviews.